Hello students, hope you are doing good. So in today's lecture we'll be discussing Euler's method. Okay, so this is the simplest and oldest method that is used to find the numerical solution of an ordinary differential equation. Okay, so the differential equation must be of first order, and we'll solve this with the help of certain boundary conditions. Okay, so this particular method falls into the category of initial value problems. Okay, so the equation is of the form dy by dx is equal to f of xy, where f is the function and x and y are the points, okay, belonging to that particular function at some boundary condition. So it means that there are certain boundary conditions that has been provided to us. So the boundary conditions are y x naught is equal to y naught. It means that the value of y at x is equal to x naught is given as y naught. Okay, so there is, you can say there is a graph that is drawn between the x-axis and the y-axis, such that we have to calculate the value of y at certain values of x. So as the x is approaching, okay, we have to calculate the value of y at every point of x. So as we can see in the graph, okay, that has been depicted here, the value of y naught at some point x naught has been, okay, given to us because this is the boundary condition. So for x is equal to x naught, we can easily trace the value of y equal to y naught as this is the boundary condition. And if we follow the successive path, then we have to calculate the value of y1 with the help of x1, and there reaches a point where we have to calculate the value of y when we have been provided the value of x as xn. Okay, so xn is the value, it is the point through at which we have to calculate the value of the function y. So we can say that y is equal to fx is the solution of this differential equation dy by dx is equal to f of xy. But the problem here is we don't know, okay, that at the point x is equal to xn, what is the value of the function? Okay, so this is not known to us, but we are given only the boundary conditions, that is x naught and y naught, and this differential equation. So we have to, okay, we have to derive, okay, certain formulas with the help of which we can calculate the value of y with the help of the value of x. Okay, so we can say that the functional value at fxn is unknown to us, and we have to calculate this functional value of f of xn, that is equal to y, with the help of the increasing value of x. Okay, so how we can find this? Okay, we can find it with the help of a Taylor series. Okay, so you have to derive a Taylor series. So we will not go deep into the Taylor series. I just explain that what exactly, okay, is the solution to this particular type of problem. So so we can just, okay, write it as y1 is equal to y naught plus h y naught dash plus h square by 2 factorial y naught double dash, and so on. Okay, where this h is the step size. Okay, this is the step size. Now we have just, okay, we have just taken the sub intervals between the point x naught and xn. So we have just break these intervals. Okay, we have taken the equal intervals, and the step size of each interval is of size h. Okay, so now we are more interested, okay, in reaching to a point from x equal to x naught, okay, to x is equal to xn, because this is the point xn at which we have to calculate the value of y. Okay, we have to calculate the value of the function, and x naught and y naught are the initial values that has been provided to us. Okay, so these are the initial values that has been provided to us. Okay, H is the step size. Okay, so if we are working in a program, okay, so we can just read this value of H. Okay, so we must try to fix this H as small as possible. Okay, so now we'll just go into the algorithm. So the step one is you have to define the function. You have to take the function in the form of f of xy. You have to read the initial conditions. Okay, so the initial values of x naught and y naught you have to read with the help of the scanf. Step three is you have to read the step size. Okay, you will just ask the step size from the user. Okay, with the help of the console, and the value of xn. Okay, so this xn is the value of x at which you have to calculate the value of the y. Okay, at which you have to calculate the value of the function. Okay, so this is the particular point. Okay, at which we have to calculate the value of y. Step 4 is we have to just initialize the initial values as x equal to x naught and y equal to y naught. We are just storing this in the variables x and y so that these values, okay, are very important to us, so that if we don't initialize it like this, so it can be lost. Okay, so we have to just use these values again and again, okay, in our program. Okay, so now the condition is while x is less than equal to xn. Okay, so the initial value x is now x naught and it is less than equal to xn. Okay, so xn is the point, okay, at which we have to calculate the value of y. Okay, so for example, if I write, let us say, if I take x naught equal to 0, okay, and I just take y naught equal to 1, so the condition says and xn is equal to, let us suppose, 3. Okay, so now we have to calculate the value of this yn at this xn. So now what is the case? Okay, the condition will be now this 0 is less than equal to 3. Okay, so the condition is now fulfilled, the condition is true, so it will go inside the loop, and now we'll just calculate the value of k. So this k is here the weight. Okay, it is the weight or it is the constant in terms of the program. Okay, so now as we have derived, okay, the equation that y1 is equal to y0 plus, okay, h y naught dash plus h square by 2 factorial y double dash, okay, y naught double dash. So this is the Taylor series. Okay, this is the expansion of the Taylor series. So what we'll do, we'll just neglect, okay, the higher powers of h, okay, and we'll just take the lower powers. Okay, so we'll just concentrate for small intervals of h or small intervals. Okay, so now we'll just formulate this equation, or we'll just reduce this equation as y1 equal to y naught plus h y naught dash. Okay, so if I write this equation in a general term, in a generic term, so I just write this equation like this: y of n is equal to y of n minus 1 plus h, that is the step size, and this y naught dash is what? This is dy by dx. Okay, so this dy by dx is equal to y naught dash, and this is equal to f of x y. Okay, so this is given to us. So for this y naught dash, we'll just write f of, okay, x naught comma y naught, because this is the initial condition. Okay, so again, if I try to just reduce this in a more generic form, so it can be written as yn is equal to yn minus 1 plus h of f xn minus 1 comma yn minus 1. Okay, so this is the formula that we have to use, okay, that we have to use in this Euler's method. Okay, so this is the equation. Okay, so now what I am just doing, I am just writing this like this: yn is equal to yn minus 1 plus h times, okay, into f of x of n minus 1 comma y of n minus 1, and I am just taking this h into f of x n minus 1 comma y of n minus 1, this whole term as equal to k. Okay, so here we have just written k equal to h into f of x y. So how it has come? It has come with the help of this expansion of Taylor series. So we have just derived it. Okay, So now we'll just calculate the initial with the help of the initial values, the value of this k, and h is given to us. Okay, we'll assume if it is not given to us, then we'll just assume it some small value. Okay, and we'll just calculate the value of this function. Okay, for example, the if the function is like this, okay, dy by dx is equal to, for example, 3x plus 6y. For example, this is the function, then we'll just write, okay, h is, for example, if h is 0.01, so we'll just write 0.01 into 3 of x naught plus 6 of y naught. Okay, and x naught and y naught are the initial conditions that has been provided to us. We will just read it with the help of the standard function. Okay, so now the value of x, the value of k has been calculated. I have calculated the value of k. Now I'll just calculate the value of y. So if I want to calculate the value of y2 for the iteration second, so how I'll calculate the value of y2? So if for n equal to 2, it will be like that, y2 is equal to y1 plus h into f of x1 comma y1. Okay, so y1 will be calculated with the help of the initial conditions. Okay, so how I calculate y1? I'll just calculate the y1 like this. Okay, so now y1 is equal to y0. If I just put this in this equation, okay, y1 equal to y0 plus h of f into x naught comma y naught, and this x naught and y naught are provided to us. Okay, these are the initial boundary conditions. So, and this y naught is also provided to us. So easily y1 is calculated. Okay, now this y1 will become the initial condition for y2, and subsequently the y2 will become the initial condition for y3. Okay, in the same way, we'll just increment the value of x. Okay, so for for calculating, you can say x1, it will be like x1 is equal to x0 plus h. Okay, so we'll just calculate the value of x1 as the boundary condition is provided to us, and the value of h is also provided to us. Now if I want to calculate the value of x2, so how I calculate the value of x2? X2 will be now x1 plus h, and x1 we have calculated. Okay, so each time the value of x and y will also be changed, okay, for the next iterations. Okay, so the new values of x and y will be treated as the input, okay, for the subsequent values for x and y that has to be calculated. Okay, so in a same way, okay, we will just reach at a point at which we have to calculate the value of y at certain point, that is at x equal to xn, we have to calculate the value of y. Or we can just write this in the form that if I want to calculate the value of y at x equal to n, then we just calculate it with the help of this particular formula. Okay, and just we'll print the value of x and y, and step 6 is the end. Okay, so here xn represents the value that is corresponding to which we have to find the value of y. So this is the algorithm, this is the basic algorithm. And now what you have to do, you have to just implement this with the help of a C program and just try to develop the program in an optimized way. So I hope now this is clear to you. Thanks.